Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. And I'm the host, Damon Pettit. A little bit distracted. I'm in a different area, which is good. And we're going to be doing a cigar I've not had. It's a fairly new cigar. And it might be fairly yummy. It is the CAO Earthquake. And this baby is, it's got Nicaraguan wrapper binder, some Nicaraguan filler, and also Honduran filler. I've always been enjoying the CAO cigars, so we'll see how this one is. Sorry, somebody just sent me a message, so I sent it back. Okay, here we go. And just so you know, if this is the first time you've ever seen me do a cigar review, I do them in weird places. I usually do it at night just because of it's kind of like the best time for me. And I don't always do them at night, but most of them seem to be. And I don't know. It's just how it is. And I sit here and I just hang out, talk. Smoke the cigar, let you know what I think. But anyway, these, if I remember right, it's kind of a series they have based on region. And you would think this would be a California cigar, but it's not. Like I said, it's pretty much almost a puro Nicaraguan. It'll be interesting to see if this has a big punch or if it's nice, strong, but smooth. I don't know. Nice draw. 6x54, 6 inches by 54 ring gauge right there. Very nice draw. So far, with just the first quick light here, I have some real grassy, deep, burned grassy notes going on. I'm actually going to pair it with a coffee, and because I happen to actually really, really enjoy Illy coffee, I just bought this, but never had these before, so we'll see how it is. Hopefully it doesn't taste like shit, but Illy coffee, usually pretty damn good when you get it. Tastes like coffee. But not bad, it's pretty good. These are supposed to come in a box of 10, and there's only 15,000 boxes made. And I didn't get that from their website. It is not really... They didn't have the Earthquake cigar in there. I think they had the Hurricane cigar. I believe there's 4 different ones in this little series of cigars that they're doing. And so I kind of had to do some searching, some looking around, learn a little bit about it. So hopefully I've got the information correct and it wasn't from an erroneous, crazy person. so far not bad. It's definitely got a little bit of a bite to it, some strength going there, which does not surprise me. I was really, because when I saw it, I grabbed it just because I knew I hadn't smoked it yet. Didn't know anything about it. But I was kind of, like when I was looking for the information on it, I was really hoping it was going to be a Brazilian wrapper. It's not. I really happen to really enjoy the Brazilian tobacco. Don't know why for sure, but ones I have had, really nice flavor. So I am actually, I don't even know if I should say. I was almost going to go to the place that I've been going, which is really close to where I reside, where my residence is, and I happened to actually go a little past it on accident. Apparently I forget where I live half the time. But and then I scooped into this little area, which is there, it's a little, what do you want to call it, a strip mall. And here there's a Quiznos. And so I'm sitting out at these outdoor tables at Quiznos. They're all chained up and everything, and so I'm kind of, I had to scooch in between the chain, hang out. Now see, I would go to a more luxurious place. If I was doing like wine or something like that, I might go someplace where there are a lot more people. But since a cigar, one, there are laws about, you know, smoking outside in so many different places out here. And, like, I couldn't do this during open hours or I'd be kicked out. But, anyway, I would be around where there are a bunch of people or whatever, but I don't want to offend anybody. Like, at my little area, that there's a really nice area with pool and stuff like that. But it is Memorial Day weekend, and I don't want to, you know, there's going to be a lot of people at the pool, so. I'm liking the flavor of this cigar so far, and it's not flavored, but I like what I'm getting. It's got a layered amount of notes in my mouth, you know, like, it's not just somebody putting a big thing of tobacco on my tongue and just leaving it there. It's kind of like I get brushed with a few different flavors. I know I make really no sense at all, and that's just how it is. But really, it's given me more of a texture, more of a, I actually explained the taste that I had with a Zevia soda to somebody, and her they looked at me like I was insane. It's just how they are to me sometimes, the different tastes. Beautiful out here. For the next week, it's supposed to be in the 90s, which still blows me away. Since I've been out here in 2000, it's never been this mild. So the different changes in the Earth's weather is definitely, it's affecting here, but it's kind of in a nice way, I guess. It's not as blistering hot. Who knows what's going to happen down the road, but. And honestly, if it's better for the environment, I would really rather it be blistering hot, but I don't know, so. I'll try to concentrate on our conversation more than my surroundings, but I've, like I said, I've not been here. I'm just kind of looking around the area a little bit. There's really not shit around here. But if I want to get my nails done another time, I know I can come in this area. Ah, tattoo. Hello. I don't have any tattoos. Someday I might, but I kind of doubt I will. If I do, it'll be a tattoo that really has meaning or something like that, I guess. I guess that makes it okay for me. I don't know. I just have never gone and gotten a tattoo. Nothing I've ever really wanted bad enough stitched into my body. That was a motorcycle, if you couldn't tell. This is not very, it's not a harsh cigar. It's definitely a little bit of a, it's got some good strength to it. But it's not harsh in any way right now. It's not, it doesn't have this acidic feel. It's quite decent so far, so far so good. It's burning quite nicely at the moment, if you can tell. I don't know, can you see that? Today is the 24th or 25th. Really, I have no idea.
25th.
And tomorrow is Memorial Day,
so
sticking with tradition and sports, they had the Indy 500 today, and I watched the last about 20 laps of that. I'm just doing a bunch of other stuff, so I didn't care that much. I personally have missed the entire IndyCar season so far. Mainly based on, I never find them on TV anymore. They're always on some, it's always kind of hard for me to freaking find them anyway. But as far as the, the race goes, it was pretty decent.
Enjoyed it.
I'm trying to remember. Oh my God. It's been, oh, now I can't even remember the person who freaking just, that's all right. Can't remember who won. If you watched it, you know who won, and if you didn't watch it, you probably don't care who won, so we're all up to date. But anyway, the end of the race was pretty decent. It was pretty close. It was pretty decent to watch that part of it. And so there's that. I'm trying to think if there's anything else going on with in the sporting world. They had the Coca-Cola 600 on. Now, one thing about that, and it's not the first time this has happened, but there was a race driver, who raced in the Indy 500, and then he flew to Charlotte to race in the Coca-Cola 600. Now, his engine blew in the Coca-Cola 600, so he didn't finish that race. He finished in sixth place, though, at the Indy 500. And that is actually a pretty good deal because he hadn't He'd never raced an Indy 500 before, and so I was pretty happy for that guy that he was able to do that well, so. Nice amount of smoke comes out of these babies. I've never had any problems with consistency on these cigars. Never had any problem with them. I don't think I've had one bad one as far as the way it smoked. I've never had a bad one as far as the different tastes that I got from them. So, and this one is following suit very well. And I mean, very, very flashy. I like the colors, though, I do. I kind of really like those bright colors. It's funny, because I'm usually wearing a watch that's about that color, but not today. Very, very creamy texture, taste right now. It's going very well with a creamy coffee. So it would go good with a lot of different wines as well, water. Definitely nice. So far, I would recommend it, especially, I believe it was just right at $8. Wait a minute, let me see, is that right? Yeah, I think right about $8. And for the size, for the way it's smoking, everything, it's definitely a decent price point for this cigar. I have done a few other CAO cigar reviews, and I was trying to think. With the, I'll put links down in the description, at least on YouTube and Vimeo. On my website, it's just going to be the video, so. Until I can get some different things going with that, with my actual website, as far as having some of that in there, then you'll just have to. I don't use my website isn't as much of a hub as I'd like it to be. At some point, I want people to just always be able to just always want to go there. But right now, that obviously is not the case. And that's fine, because I don't pay anybody to do that. I do it all myself, so I'm not losing money or anything like that doing that. Any other news, my friends? Let me see. I don't believe so. Any of you out there use Uber, U-B-E-R, to go from place to place? I know that probably a lot of people in New York use it, maybe California. If you use it, let me know. Let me know what you think about it and stuff like that. I'm just interested in it, that's all. I've heard good things, so we'll see. Really burning nice. I'm actually holding on to the ash, which you know I don't usually do that. There is no wind factor out here today at all. which is nice. There is actually a slight breeze, but it's not really hitting me here. Just checking things out, making sure there's nobody behind me. Just gonna see about taking a picture up here real quick, just to take a look. Voila. Okay, people. Well, I'm trying to think if there... I don't have anything new to share with you today, you know? So... buzz off. I'm just really just kidding. Oh, here's something I want to talk about. Almost forgot about this. Yesterday, it's burning very nice. Yesterday there was something going on that I don't know if anybody knows about, because I really didn't hear much about it. I don't watch the news, and I don't think I caught much of the news yesterday. I do end up watching the news when my roommates are watching during dinner and stuff. So, because we usually kind of sit down and kind of like a family time. We all eat. But we sometimes have the news on at that point because they're watching it. And but I don't remember it being on. If it was, I didn't hear anything about it, and that is, I'm talking about the March Against Monsanto. Kind of an important thing here in the United States of America. It really is. If you don't know anything about it, I would definitely look it up. I would kind of read up on it, and... it is definitely, it started out, company, it's same people that made Agent Orange and, you know, killed a lot of people with that. And they also make all kinds of insecticides, and they make fertilizers. They make weed killer. They own all kinds of companies like Roundup, stuff like that. And they're the ones who are pretty much responsible for the whole genetically modified foods. Genetically modified food, not really what we all should have it. It might have even started out as wanting to help, wanting to, you know, be able to grow crops that were fruitful and could feed many people, that kind of thing. But it has now turned into a company that not only is greedy and pretty powerful, but it's dangerous, and they are also banned in many countries, like Japan, Australia, New Zealand. I mean, just like, they are banned almost everywhere but the United States of America. And unfortunately for us, the reason why they are not banned here is because they, like kind of the oil companies, are one of the businesses that help own the United States of America. And that's, to me, very sad. I love my country and everything, but I do not like the direction that it has gone. And to me, it's very sad that our politicians don't do things based on what's actually best for America. They do things, you know, when they're getting their asses scratched, when they're, you know, getting some cash. I think that talks more than anything for them. So, anyway, genetically modified food not cool. If you're interested at all, one, and you don't want to read a bunch of shit, one thing you can look at is a documentary called Food Inc. I believe I've mentioned it before. If you watch me all the time, then maybe you've heard it. But Food Inc. is a very good documentary. Huge bit of a wake-up thing. It's not all roses and fun to watch. It gives you the real shit of what's going on. And it's not a conspiracy thing, you know. It's not a bunch of crazy people that, you know, think that the world is against them. There's all kinds of good going on out there. There are beautiful cops. There are beautiful politicians. There are beautiful people roaming the earth everywhere. There are people helping people everywhere. But there are also groups of people and groups of companies, all these different things also that are not so good and not very helpful to our way of life. And one way to kind of tell whether they may be good or may be bad. If you didn't hear anything about the march against Monsanto, if you really didn't hear any, don't remember hearing it, or don't remember anything about it, that right there should tell you, because it's a pretty huge thing. And when the news doesn't want to, you know, give us the actual news, that's one thing you want to see. So, there are so many different facts about it that just make you want to puke, not even funny. Like the, I believe it's, pretty sure, the head of the FDA, I believe it's the FDA, used to be, the the lead lawyer for Monsanto. I don't know. I don't want to just say, go learn about Monsanto and then leave it there, you know? If I'm going to bring it up, I should at least tell you something about it, so there we go. One of the biggest things that showed me that they are definitely a disgusting organization, a horrible company, and literally should be wiped out as far as business-wise, is what they do to farmers. And what they did at least with the soybean, is they genetically modified it. Trying to make it more resistant to bugs and crap like that, to natural things on Earth, you know. And they then they put a patent on that soybean. And then they would force farmers to use that soybean. And they would not allow the farmers to save the seeds from their natural soybeans that weren't genetically modified. And if these farmers got caught doing that, Monsanto would sue them to the point to where they would lose their farm. And they didn't just do this to one guy. They are literally doing this to anybody. They are not good. They're not good for anything, honestly. So, America really needs to kind of wake up. You know, we really need to get our heads out of our asses, get our heads out of our phones. Or if we're on our phones, we better be doing something so that we're learning a little bit about what's going on. I mean, there are just too many things to where we trust too many people to be making decisions that they're really fucking us with. And it's a real shitty thing, because I would like to be able to go buy some food, eat it, and not worry about what's been put in my food. And I'm not even talking about Monsanto now. I'm just talking about food in general that you go to the store and it says it's either all natural or something like that, and there's shit that doesn't need to even be in there. But because it's in there, it makes it cheaper to make, and we're eating it, slowly killing ourselves. So, luckily if the human body was very, very, very delicate, which it all kind of is, but if it was delicate, I don't think we would even be around anymore. If you think of all the shit that we put in our bodies, with the exception of the few people that are 100% organic and 100% eating nothing but the best, and I don't know if anybody's out there like that, but if there is, they're the exception. But most of us are, you know, even what's in this. I have no idea what's in this because I can't see it. But, I see more people racing through here. Hopefully it's not too loud, not too ridiculous. Because I can lose in the mic again. But like this thing of coffee here. Let's see if I can even tell you what's in it. Oh, I know. Yeah, hold on a minute. Hold on. Okay, ready? This is just a thing of coffee that I'm drinking. And of course, it is the latte macchiato. I didn't really even, I just grabbed it because I saw Yoli coffee. But it, coffee, and then milk, sugar, potassium carbonate, I don't know what that even is, potassium citrate. I know a lot of these are like probably agents that preserve shit, I don't know. Cellulose gels, cellulose gum, and something else. Wow. And what's really funny is this is produced for the Coca-Cola company. Really, Illy? Because if you know anything about them, it's usually a coffee that doesn't even come from here, but fuck that. Now I wish I wouldn't have been showing their ass around, but anyway, that's what I'm saying. You, if you start reading the labels on all your food, you start, what the hell? It's sad, you know? Even if you go to a Whole Foods or a Sprouts or an all-natural food store, organic food store, not everything in there is really good either. There's lots of things in those stores, lots of things in Walmart, lots of things in the Kroger stores and Safeways that are actually very good, very good for you, all that kind of crap. But the main diets of everybody, I think, we eat shit that we shouldn't be eating. So I'm just letting you know, that's kind of the kind of guy I am. I look at different crap, and I hope to see the truth and stuff, and not, you know, I wish I didn't have to read any labels. I wish I could say, oh, I'm having coffee that I'm sure probably has cream in it and some sugar. I knew it was going to be sweetened. But no. And there are some of those things that might not even do anything to your body. Might be fine. But the different chemicals that we have now are just crazy. So just keep your eyes open for yourself. Don't worry about, you know, you got to do what's best for you, for your family. I know there are a lot of people that can literally only afford to buy about the cheapest possible foods so that they can keep their family eating. And I've been there. And I would, something happened,
I would do it again. You know, but if I don't have to, I'm definitely not going to. So just keep your eyes open of stuff, and don't just get your news from the news. Don't just get your news from a web page, because it could be any psycho person it could be me, you know. You just never know. So that was my biggest thing. The whole Monsanto thing pissed me off, just because I didn't see it anywhere. Even in those stores that I mentioned, not a fucking thing about it. They've got different stuff everywhere about everything, but not one word about that little march that was going on. So that really irritates me. But I'm still trying to enjoy life, live life, and that's what you all need to do. We all need to do what we can to feed ourselves, feed our families, help people around us, and just stay awake, you know. Know what your politicians are doing, and just try to always do the right thing. That's, I guess, the best thing to try to do. So, anyway, I think that's my rant for the day, huh? This cigar is an excellent cigar. It really is. Like I said, the quality of these cigars have not let me down yet, and they still haven't at the moment, so that's good. I'm glad to see that. Beautifully rolled. Again, I really enjoy the, like that color a lot. So, as far as to the eye, it's very pleasing. To the palate, it's also very pleasing. To the whole mechanics of it, it's extremely pleasing. I'd like to shake the hand, give a fist pump and a high five to the person that rolled this, because they did a very good job. And I am here in Arizona, the United States, smoking it and talking all about it. And that's pretty crazy if you think about it. So, hope everybody's doing well. I hope you're doing good. I hope you're not working too hard. I hope that your job is fun and that your life is decent, if not just fantastic. And if you happen to be going through some shit right now, just hold on to the small good things that you know about in your life. And you can't worry about all the other little stuff. You gotta hang on to the good stuff. Just keep going. And pretty soon, the crap will start to fall away. It's like peeling a banana. Pretty soon you get to the nice banana and you get to eat it. Hang in there. Keep peeling away. Eat that fucking banana. Or onion, or whatever it is you eat. Garlic. Pomegranate. Thank you very much for watching. I really, really appreciate it. Thank you for hanging out with me. And, listening to me rant. Thank you for comments when you leave them. I really appreciate that. I don't get tons of comments, but I do get comments, and I try to reply to all of them, even though there's not always that many. But I start to do a bunch of stuff, and for some reason I don't always get notifications. It's starting to be a little better, so I do usually see them when they're, you know, if it's on Vimeo or YouTube. Both of them are starting to do pretty good as far as let me know that somebody's commented. So, if I don't reply right away, please don't hate me. Feel free to email me. I'm trying to check my Cigar Review TV email a lot more. So, you should get a reply pretty decently within a week.
I need to honestly check that and do that better and reply right away, like within the next day. So I will be working on that, I promise. And again, thank you very much. I really appreciate you hanging with me. I hope you're smoking a great cigar and enjoying something, some part of your life. And I look forward to smoking with you again. I'm going to sit back a little bit, watch the traffic go by, and enjoy the rest of this one. Take care, you guys and gals. I love you all. Bye.